discussing here are some sequences, some studies concerning what is a horo and the usage and employment of this cane that it's called tsue. The idea here is when we are not only in front of other enemy that also is carrying or holding a cane, but also it could be a sword, you will see. The idea is when we are attacking and we put the enemy in a position that we could make to drop the weapon. And after that, we need to continue the movement at the same direction that you are making to lose the weapon. And for another example, if I attack up, now I attack down, I could enter like that, and with this, I could take out, strike, and strike in a long strike. Very common mistakes here could be the following. If I maybe attack on the same place, up and down, if I try to go to this point, this is not the closest direction. Because if we are here, if we try to go to this point, it will be a lot of time, and of course he could react. For example, if I am here, he could strike on my face, strike and recover the position. Then from here, the idea is to enter and guarantee. The second common mistake is if I take out from this point, maybe to go back, to return from that point. But this is not the idea. If I have dropped the weapon from the enemy to this direction, I need to continue in this direction. And it's very important to be a continuous movement like that. Another possibility here, it could be, for example, if I try to go in a direct strike like that, and right now I attack to one side, one, and up, for example, I could make that the tip goes to that point, and after that, I could, from here, take, and I could strike one, strike two in the same direction. Then there are several possibilities in order to explain this horo with this walking stop, walking stick. Another possibility from here, striking up the side, and right now from here I could enter and now take out in order to strike one, strike two. Time, for example, if I strike one side, the other, I have conditions here to go to that point, and from here I could release and striking one and two. Remember that horo has the characteristic to repeat the same attack in the same direction in a circular movement with a very fast motion. The idea is not giving conditions to react. For example, in this case, Lu Jordan is us. He is holding us up. We could perform before if he, for example, tries to come, I could strike one, strike two. For example, before he attacks. But of course, we could also, for that, if he tries to go, I could strike one, I could strike two, in this direction. Or like that. One, two, or of course, I could go inside in order to release and at the same movement I am making. Here, I could strike one, strike two. And it's another possibility that we could happen. Of course, when he tries to, I could go striking one, striking two to the head with this fast motion. One more time. When he is coming, I could apart the sword and strike. like that, I pull strike on the head once and strike on the arm, on the head one more time. And it will be also applied to every weapon maybe, because we could be dealing with the troll master or a spear master. Then the idea is that we apply this weapon with this kind of skill warriors that could defend with the sword, or violent attacks or very fast attacks that we are performing in order to give us conditions to avoid any kind of reaction from the sword, from the spear, or from the cane itself. And after that we will be applying one of the most important things, that it's our speed, that we are performing these both movements with a very, very fast motion. I hope that you have enjoyed this explanation, further explanation on what is Hodo method.